Sometimes, it's hard to imagine a time before electricity and gadgets like TVs, cell phones, or even radios. So, it can be easy to forget the incredible technology that was invented long before modern times. In this SciFive, we go all the way back to ancient civilizations to explore some of the fascinating advanced inventions that were already in use. Before we get into it, if you find yourself enjoying this video, give it a thumbs up and hit subscribe. Number 5. Greek Fire. Greek fire, which has also been known by names such as sea fire, war fire, and liquid fire, is credited as the reason behind many Byzantine military victories. Perhaps the most important is the salvation of Constantinople from two Arab sieges, which secured the empire's survival. For those who are not completely familiar with the Byzantine Empire, it was a large and powerful civilization that was founded as a new Rome by Roman Emperor Constantine I on the site of the ancient Greek colony of Byzantium. It can be traced back to 330 AD and didn't dissolve until 1453. In 672, the empire developed a game-changing weapon for their military forces. This was the Greek fire, a liquid combustible compound that could be used in flame-throwing devices to set fire to enemies. Incredibly, the compound ignited on contact with water and would continue to burn on the surface, which made it extremely useful for their naval fleets. The empire developed projectors that would fire the liquid through a tube, as well as pressurized nozzles that resemble modern-day flamethrowers, which could be directed to project the chemical liquid onto a chosen enemy, and they even developed grenades containing the liquid. The Byzantine princess and scholar Anna Comnene gave this account on the description of a projector. On the prow of each ship, he had a head fixed of a lion or other land animal, made in brass or iron with the mouth open and then gilded over so that their mere aspect was terrifying. And the fire, which was to be directed against the enemy through the tubes he made pass through the mouths of the beasts so that it seemed as if the lions and the other similar animals were vomiting the fire. The weapon made quite an impact on enemy civilizations, to the point where they began to try to replicate it. Around 812, Bulgars managed to steal several siphons of the liquid itself, and in an 827 battle with the Arabs, the enemy was able to capture at least one intact ship that had the Greek fire. But even with the weapon in their hands, the perfect formula was a mystery to all but the Byzantines. The formula, of course, was a very closely guarded secret of the empire. In his book, De Administrando Imperio, Emperor Constantine Porphyrogenitas warns his son never to reveal the secret by saying it was shown and revealed by an angel to the great and holy first Christian Emperor Constantine, and that the angel bound him not to prepare this fire but for Christians and only in the imperial city. The Greek fire is continuously mentioned in Byzantine battles up until around 1200. After that, mentions peter out of history. This is thought to be due to the general disarmament of the empire, or perhaps the loss of a crucial ingredient. The ingredients have long been debated, but it seems that the secret has gone with the empire itself. Number 4. Robot Band. With this entry, it seems that robots have been taking over human jobs long before the Industrial Revolution, or even electricity itself. Ismail al-Jazari was a Muslim inventor, mathematician, and scholar in the Islamic Golden Age. The age itself dates from about the 8th century to the 14th century. Al-Jazari was alive between 1136 and 1206. During his lifespan, he became an incredibly successful scientist and inventor, and his work on automata was even said to have influenced the famous Leonardo da Vinci. In this specific project, Al-Jazari mixed art and science to create the perfect entertainment for a party, a robotic band. By using hydraulic switching and other techniques, which he wrote about in his most famous work, The Book of Knowledge of Ingenious Mechanical Devices, he was able to create programmable robot musicians. The entire invention was a boat that featured four humanoid automata that floated on the water while playing music to entertain the guests at royal parties. Robotics expert Noel Sharkey says he was able to produce a possible replica of the device, but scientists still aren't completely sure how Al-Jazari did it. Sharkey says in his version, the drum machine was programmable by means of moving pegs that would bump into small levers. The drums could play to different rhythms and patterns as the pegs were moved around. Because of this, Sharkey argues that this invention was perhaps one of the earliest forms of programmable automata. Al-Jazari also had some other notable inventions when it comes to automata. Another one I thought worth mentioning was a female humanoid automaton that could serve drinks, essentially an ancient robotic bartender. Drinks would be filled up by a reservoir that dips into a bucket and then into a cup. After the cup is filled, the waitress would appear out of the automatic door serving the drink. Al-Jazari was an incredible inventor and well ahead of his time. If these concepts interest you, I highly recommend reading more about him. Number 3, the Lycurgus Cup. This incredible and beautiful invention is from the 4th century. Extremely rare, the cup has been described as the most spectacular glass of the period, fittingly decorated, which we know to have existed. And for good reason. This decorative Roman cup was made from a special type of glass that shows different colors depending on the direction of the light. If light is passing from the front of the cup, it will illuminate green. When in the reverse, it will illuminate red. The glass used is called dichroic glass. The modern form used today was developed as a result of research done by NASA, which only makes the 4th century usage even more incredible. Dichroic glass is made by creating glass with nanoparticles of gold and silver dispersed throughout the material. Researchers still do not know the process used by the Romans and believe the only way they could have developed such a material is by accident. Many believe a batch of glass contaminated with silver and gold dust led the Romans to the invention. In fact, the traces for the effect need to be so small, researchers ponder whether the Romans knew what happened at all, and if the cup itself was a complete accident. But even though the cup is extremely rare, there are other examples throughout history of similar objects. So how could they not have known? Well, the answer is as simple as it can get. The mistake miraculously happened multiple times. The other surviving objects with the effect of the dichroic glass vary in their two colors, which could prove they couldn't really hone the discovery they had made. It would also explain why the objects are so rare. Corning Glassworks worked to recreate the Lycurgus effect, which is when the green and red colors occur. They found that the particles involved are only about 70 nanometers across, and cannot be seen with a regular microscope. Therefore, a transmission electron microscope is necessary. So if it wasn't an accident, the Romans were clearly far, far ahead of their time. But this isn't the only thing that makes this cup so fascinating to historians. It is also the only well-preserved physical example of a cage cup. A cage cup is made when the glass used is cut and ground back to create an exterior design. Usually, the designs are geometric abstract designs, but this one is special in that it features the mythical king Lycurgus, for whom the cup is named after. It currently sits in the British Museum. Number 2, Greek programmable robots. In 1550, the famous art historian Giorgio Vasari wrote in his book Lives of the Most Excellent Painters, Sculptors, and Architects of an encounter he had with Leonardo da Vinci. He said, quote, "When Leonardo was at Milan, the king of France came there and desired him to do something curious. Accordingly, he made a lion whose chest opened after he had walked a few steps, discovering himself to be full of lilies." To more modern readers, this seemed incredible and very unexplainable. Even for Da Vinci, this was a very complicated machine that was reported. It wasn't until 2000 when US robotics expert Mark Rosheim put the pieces together and was able to explain it. In his research, Rosheim found that the lion was powered by a self-propelled cart that appeared in Da Vinci's famous Codex Analyticus. The cart was powered by coiled springs that even had brakes and steering capabilities. But despite its great potential, it seemed to have been designed mainly for theatrical purposes. Regardless of its use, it was so incredibly ahead of its time that it was not replicated until 2006 by Italy's Institute and Museum of the History of Science in Florence. Experts have actually compared the built machine to the Mars Land Rover. Now, obviously Da Vinci was not from ancient Greece, so where did I get that headline? A researcher on the website New Scientist decided to go back even further than the 1500s to see if it was possible that Da Vinci got his inspiration from a previous invention. And whether or not we are able to connect Da Vinci to the ancient Greeks here, he did find a strikingly similar invention that predates Da Vinci by about 1500 years. The Greek mathematician Hero of Alexandria researched and wrote about many things on the topics of hydraulics, mnemonics, other mechanics, and much more. In his writings, it also seems he had already invented a programmable cart very similar to that of Da Vinci's. This cart was made of three wheels and was propelled by a falling weight, but it was different from Da Vinci's in that it was programmable by means of string, essentially. Depending on the complex arrangement of the string wrapped around different pegs on the device's base, you could have the cart move forward, turn, stop, and move backwards in whichever pattern you wanted. Truly a programmable machine way ahead of its time. Number 1. The Antikythera Mechanism. In 1901, divers were retrieving artifacts off of Point Glyphadia on the Greek island of Antikythera, from a site deemed the Antikythera Shipwreck. The wreck contained many large artifacts, such as statues of bronze and marble, jewelry, pottery, coins, and other interesting pieces of history from the ancient Greeks. Among those pieces of history was a strange lump of bronze and wood that didn't seem to resemble much. All of the artifacts were brought to the National Museum of Archaeology in Athens to be stored and analyzed, but the large lump of wood and bronze was seen as too confusing and wrecked to be worthwhile, and researchers promptly began assembling statues and studying other objects. About a year later, an archaeologist noticed that the lump featured gears and looked to be a complex mechanism tied to astronomy, but other scientists claimed that the idea was too complex, as the wreck and its artifacts were traced back to 1st century BC. It wasn't until nearly 50 years later that the strange object was given the attention it deserved. In 1951, British science historian and Yale University professor Derek J. DeSala Price developed an interest in the object. By 1974, he and a Greek nuclear physicist created X-ray and gamma-ray images of the 82 pieces and published a 70-page report on their findings. It was discovered to be an advanced astronomical computer that featured 37 gears and supposedly tracked the cycles of the moon and the sun through the zodiac. It could in turn predict eclipses, the locations of the five planets that were known at the time, and even follow the irregular orbit of the moon. The writings on the machine were found to be Greek, but the calendar it followed was actually a Sothic Egyptian calendar. The computer system was incredibly complex for its time, and its origins are still debated, with some researchers even linking it to the school of Archimedes. Archimedes, of course, is the famous Greek mathematician known for many things, among them the discovery of pi. There are many estimations as to the exact time the machine is from, as its erosion makes it hard to pinpoint. Most guesses land between 205 BC and 87 BC. Regardless, the machine is widely referred to as the first known analog computer. Thanks to intense research, it has now been replicated many times. In fact, you can buy your own exact replica directly from the Museum of Ancient Greek Technology's website. Thank you for checking out this SciFive. If you liked this video, don't forget to like and subscribe. Also, check out my last video, 5 Terrifying Sleep Conditions, and be sure to stay tuned for future SciFives on all things science and science fiction. And as usual, I'd like to give a big shout out to my Patreon supporters.